want to talk about WWE 2K23 and mostly my experiences with it. And a lot of people, yes, the game has just come out. A lot of people, you know, I've seen a little bit of mixed reactions on it. But I want to talk about my experiences with it because they're different than probably everyone else. Not a bad thing, not a good thing, not a bad thing. So I'm going to start out just prior to talking about the game, I'm going to talk about my experience with the 2K games in general. I didn't get a PS4 until 2018, 2017, so I was a little late to the system, but I would have a PS3, so I would always get the newest wrestling game during Christmas for my PS3. So by the time I got 2K15, 16, and 17, they're all on the PS3. So it was just a cut and copy game. So I didn't know what a next gen console game would play like. I didn't see it from my eyes. I saw it through YouTube videos. That's how I saw my video. That's how I saw how the WWE games were supposed to look. Hold on, my glasses are annoying me. But that was one of the problems I had with the original. Like from 2014 for 2K14 to 2K17, I had for PS3, and they weren't horrible games. They still had the showcase that was in the next gen consoles, and I still enjoyed playing those. Like a lot of people, I didn't mind it. I enjoyed playing those games, but as I got a PS4 and as I started doing the more wrestling games, I wanted to pre-order WWE 2K18. A little backstory, when I pre-ordered it, Kurt Angle was the pre-order bonus, and I didn't get Kurt Angle. It didn't come with it, and what I thought would happen, I don't know what, if it was on the receipt, or if it was in, like, the game just didn't come with the code. I never got it. And it could have been on the receipt, but no one told me when I picked up the game. They never said, oh, your code's on the receipt, pick it up, enjoy. I was never told that. I was just, here's the game, have fun. So I got home, looked for the code, couldn't find it, cried a little bit, and I'm like, I'm not getting next year's game. Didn't get 2K19, didn't pre-order it, didn't get 2K19. Severely missed out. Ryan, Golden Gamer, said it was a great game, and I mean, it looked like a pretty good game. It was still played when 2K20 was coming out. And then I did the unthinkable. Not only did I pre-order WWE 2K20, I got the deluxe edition of 2K20. I want my $120 back. But at the time, I didn't know that the WWE game coming out, the newest one with Roman Reigns and Becky Lynch on the cover, was going to be the worst WWE game to ever release. I didn't know that at the time. I'm like, oh my god, it's been 2 years since I've got a game. I'll get this one. It should go well. I get, what came in it? Hold on. I know the codes. The actual code was in this one. Disc and everything, code. So it came with the 20th SmackDown Anniversary Edition. This is the deluxe edition. All the playable superstars. I don't remember who it was. I'll figure that out after. All 2K20 originals, an accelerator, and a MyPlayer kickstart. I wanted the originals. I heard that those were going to be some, like, really cool things. I can get the Fiend. I can, like, it was really, that's all I wanted it for, was the Fiend, pretty much. But I'm like, I can get all these cool ideas and all these cool concepts for a video, and it before I even did videos, for, like, just to play around with. It's going to be awesome. Then the game came out, and I made a video on it. You can go, I'll probably clip that video. Nope, regret that purchase. But here it is, I can say I own the deluxe version of 2K20 in 10 years, and say I was made bad financial decisions. Then WWE themselves took a year off to develop the new game, WWE 2K22, and I did pre-order it, but I didn't get the deluxe version this time. I saved a little bit of money. Smart choice. But in the end, a couple months ago, before 2K23 was announced, I bought the season pass. So it didn't matter anyways. But when it came to 23, I pre-ordered it late. So I still got Bad Bunny. But I also pre-ordered the normal version again. And with the normal version came just, I don't know, just came Bad Bunny. And it was like, okay, cool. And I'm like, oh, maybe I can get it a couple days earlier. And I didn't get it earlier. I was kind of upset about that. But it was, I still survived. I still had it. Then I streamed it. And the first thing I noticed was, again, the background. We'll get into what I like about the game in a little bit, but first thing I noticed was the background, and the tutorial was really cool. I saw on a video that if you do the tutorial, you can get the Performance Center as a wrestling arena. Sure, why not? To get a free arena. But I was sitting there, and I'm like, I don't mind it. The game wasn't that bad, but I only played it for a select amount of time, so. And I only play the showcase. So what in this video, long intro short, I'm probably gonna put a timestamp in the thing. But long intro short, what I'm gonna be talking about is the gameplay, kind of the new additions, and the showcase. I've not really touched anything else. I've touched create a player, That's pretty much it. I've touched Creative Player, Creative Entrance. I will talk about Creative Entrance because Creative Entrance has gotten significantly better than 22. So I guess to get into it, sorry for the long intro. If you're just joining us now because you skipped the long intro, happy birthday. To who? If it's your birthday, Merry Christmas. Do I make sense half the time? No, that is ChickenTendieGaming. So let's get on with the video. I'm gonna start out, I think, with the thing that everyone wants to talk about the most is the gameplay. I don't know, it's cut and copy from 22. There's really no difference. Like, it's you still have the combos, which are the combos are all right. I didn't like them in 22. They've kind of grown on me since because I can create some cool looks, but I don't know. Not a big thing. I'm not a big fan of the combo-esque thing going on. But that's my opinion. I mean, I'm probably a minority or probably a mid. I don't know. I don't know where I am in that. It's not bad. It plays smooth. I'll give it that. It plays smooth. The AI is, you can tell it's a little more recognizable. I did feel that they did add what's the word I'm looking for? They did add rolling out of the ring, which was a pretty big thing that I think a lot of people kind of take for granted in wrestling, because you see a lot of times they take a move and they roll out of the ring. Like, I think in the game now it's almost a little too much. I think a little too much is the right answer, but if you like that idea and you like the storytelling of it, and go for it. I don't mind it. It's not horrible. Could be worse, could be better. It's not bad. It's smooth for the most part until you get to, yeah, there's really nothing I can say. You play 22, you'll know how to play 23. I don't really think there's any big gameplay changes, but I guess we can move on to the showcase. So showcase this year is John Cena, but it's all of his fattest L's that he's ever taken in his career. So something like his first match with Kurt Angle, or one night stand with RVD, or against Brock Lesnar at Survivor Series, SummerSlam in 2015 and 2016 or whatever it was. I think I'm with most people here when I say the showcase is a cool idea. If you haven't watched the career or the rivalry or whatever it's about, if you haven't watched it and you want a way to interact with it and learn how to do it, it's a cool idea. It's a great idea. But it's only for a very niche group of individuals who have not watched wrestling, or who have just gotten into it and need to learn the storyline, or need to learn, you know, what John Cena is about and those matches where he lost because he's so known for winning. The one thing that, like, really I think caught my attention was WrestleMania 34 against Undertaker. I've seen that match. I watched it live, not in New Orleans, but I watched it on TV. I don't need to relive that. I don't need to relive that. I think that Showcase should really be stuck with older content. Older, like if it's something that happened 5 years ago, that's not old enough. I think it needs to be something that happened in the 90s and the 80s where it's almost like lost. Like that needs to be showcased where it brings light to something that's not already known. A lot of people do. Sorry for any bad mic, by the way. But a lot of people already know what John Cena's losses are. They've seen them. They've watched them. But a lot of people don't know what. I don't know. I can't think of something on the spot. But, like, it's very, very difficult topic. And along with that, it's when you're playing, I don't need a narrative telling me how to get to a spot or what to do. Because unless you're going to show all the objectives right away, it's not going to go well. I'm telling you now. Because one of the things I can pull it up, I can pull up clips from my stream. One of the things is you read it. By the time you're reading it, you're already getting attacked. You can't do it. You lost whatever you need to lose. Whatever you need to do. It's hit Triple H's signature spine buster. But also, Cena's already given you an AA and pinning you. But it's like bringing it to be more simple is the word I'm looking for. And I think a lot of people don't. And a lot of people at 2K think, oh, if we just tell a story, then it's going to be something cool. No. You tell it. My camera just stopped all of a sudden. But if you, I don't know, it's Showcase's cool idea. Not really much to do on it. Create a wrestler, same thing as everything. They made it a little more realistic. I did notice that. That's about it. I don't know. Some new tires from new people. Still has their name, so you can't use any cool ones, and you have to like use a basic one. Well, I think every attire should have its own little preset with no logos or anything on it. But that's just me. Create a entrance has changed dramatically. There's a timeline. You can specifically choose when pyro goes off. You can specifically choose when the lights in the arena go, like, not they go pitch black, but you can choose certain things, and it looks, I made it, okay, I'll see if I can pull up the entrance, but I made it, and it looks pretty good. As good as I can make it. There's not really any good transitions between, just no transitions between entrance from the ramp to the stage, or from the stage to the ramp, there's not really anything like that, but it looks alright. Other than that, WWE 2K23, that's pretty much it. I haven't played My Rise yet. I haven't played My GM. That's changed. Universe, I don't really touch ever. But yeah, that's about it. So thank you for watching. Check out my Twitch, where I'm probably gonna be streaming the game a little more. If you want to see some content based off of it, let me know. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. All right. Peace. Goodbye. When in doubt, TendieToo. What's my outro again? I don't even remember my outro. But all right, see you guys in the next video. Cool.